Hi there, and welcome on board. My name is Erica, and I help design the product here at Quintly. In this short video, you'll learn a few things on how to get started. First, we'll begin by adding some social profiles, and then you'll see how easy it is to set up a dashboard with one of our templates. All right, let's get started.
First thing you need are some profiles to analyze. Let's head to the profiles section in the navigation. A social profile is basically a publicly available social media page that you would like to track. Let's add our first profile by clicking New Profile. Now you can either type out the name of the profile you're searching for, and you'd find the results for the different social networks related to that name, or you can paste the entire URL link and find that specific profile right away. Once you've selected the profile, you'll land on a confirmation step that lets you know any specific information about a page, as well as how many profiles you can still add in your account. Since everything looks good here, let's add this profile. Now that the profile has been successfully added, you have the option of adding this profile to any groups that you might have, adding an appendix, or give the profile a custom color. As you can do all of these things in the profile management area, you can as well click Done or add another profile. Once you have a few more profiles, you can organize yourself by making groups. Not only are groups a way for you to organize all your profiles, but they allow you to analyze multiple profiles at once. So let's say we're interested in analyzing a few Facebook pages from Netflix shows. I just recently added some, so I'm going to select Recently Added in the dropdown. Now all you do is select the profiles that you would like to place into the group, click Assign Group, here's where we add a new group, and we'll just give it a name. Now we just need to make sure we select the group we just created, and click Update. Now to view the group that we just created, we can select it here in the dropdown. And we can also sort the profiles by social network. Now we get to set up a dashboard for you to analyze your profiles. A dashboard is basically an overview of certain metrics, and it's also the basis for creating a report. Once you've created your different dashboards, they will show up here. To add a dashboard, you can either create a dashboard from scratch or use one of our templates. Let's head to the Discover section and try out a template. Now this is the Discover section. It's where you'll find dashboard templates and individual metrics to add to a dashboard. Templates are great for when you're not sure about which metrics to add to a dashboard. Let's say you're looking to improve the content on your Facebook page. Well, we can begin our search by looking for Facebook dashboards. And here we have dashboards with Facebook metrics. And if we look to the filters, you can see the different social network categories, as well as the different use cases. Since we're interested in optimizing content, let's also select Content Optimization. Now here we have a dashboard that compares your content with your competitors, so let's save this dashboard to our list. Now if we go back to the dashboard list, we can find that dashboard that we just created. And here's where you select which profiles you'd like to analyze, either all pages, groups, or individual metrics. Let's select that group that we just created before. Here's also where you would select the time frame and you'd like to analyze your profiles. Now, as you can see, we immediately have a dashboard that can help compare the performance of the content on your pages to your competitors. And of course, we can always add more metrics to the dashboard by clicking back to the Discover section. Now, let's add some more metrics to that content optimization dashboard we just added. You can filter through metrics the same way we did for dashboards. So first, you can filter down to Facebook metrics, and then again to content optimization. Now you'll see a result of Facebook metrics that will help optimize your content. So I'm going to select this metric here since I know it's not already included in the dashboard. And if you're not too sure about a metric, you can go into the detail page and you can actually see some sample data that has been applied to the metric, and you can even preview it with your own profiles. You can also directly export from this view, but I'm just going to add this metric to that dashboard. Now, if we take a look at that dashboard, we can see the metrics that we added at the bottom of the dashboard. And here's when we can really start to customize the dashboard to our needs. So if I'm not interested in a certain metric here, I can delete it. And if I would like to see, for instance, this metric right here in full view, I can also make this full width here, and this one as well. And as you can see, we're really customizing this dashboard to our needs. And that's it. Now you can begin deep diving into social media analytics.